Duke Johnson's trade. The Texans finally have a decent running back here. I love Duke Johnson. They acquired him for a fourth-round pick that could become a third-rounder. And one interesting point about that is Bill O'Brien's acting as the general manager right now. He wouldn't just burn a potential third-rounder in a guy that he wouldn't use. So immediately, right from the top, you know this draft capital suggests more than just a potential cautionary role. They were clearly envisioning for something for Duke Johnson. I don't like how the Texans have been very reluctant to use their running backs in the past game. Bill O'Brien's been like 28th, 30th. One year where he had over 100 targets and ranked 11th in running back targets, but otherwise it's been nothing above 26th in running back targets. So immediately you're like, ah, that sucks for Duke Johnson. But he's never had a receiving weapon like Duke Johnson out of the backfield. 90.9 grade from Pro Football Focus, the fifth highest of any running back since 2015 when he came into the league. A better stat that I really love, insane here. I know Dak wants $40 million. That's probably the most insane stat I've ever heard. But another great stat for Duke Johnson is 44% of his catches went for either first downs or touchdowns since 2015. That's the fourth highest rate in the NFL right there. Tons of other great stats about how he breaks contact after the catch and all this good stuff. All that meaning to say, this is a great pass-catching weapon in a fantastic offense that just lost Kiki Cutie. We're going to preview that in a little bit. So ultimately, there's definitely room for targets. I know the reception history has been sketchy for his running backs, but when you get a weapon like this and he pays the draft capital to get a guy like Duke Johnson, my guess is he's going to use him, and he's going to use him heavily. So I think this move is crucial. He rises right up into my top 100. He was an afterthought on draft day. Lamar Miller takes a humongous hit. Just last market check, we were sitting here raving about Lamar Miller, a true three-down horse in the league's one of the most explosive attacks in the league right now, but that's not going to be the case. We know Duke Johnson's going to at least take the third downs, and there is the upside. I think Duke's a better running back than Lamar Miller, so there's definitely a chance that he could steal this gig outright. He's been a workhorse back in his college days. He's the all-time leading rusher at Miami, where we obviously have Edgerrin James and Clinton Portis and Willis McGahee, so many decorated running backs. Duke Johnson outrushed all of them during his career there. So this guy has a workhorse past. There's definitely a chance he takes this gig. So we got a drop, of course. Lamar Miller takes a hit. Duke Johnson himself skyrockets. And then we also have to consider guys like Deshaun Watson. When I gave that stat, 44% of Duke Johnson's catches go for first downs or touchdowns. That's huge for Deshaun Watson. More sustained drives. How many times did you see this guy scrambling behind his porous line with no one to throw to? Duke will be that safety valve. He makes a lot of people miss after the catch. He's going to get a lot of receptions that go for first down, sustain the drives. That's huge for Deshaun Watson. A big stock up arrow for him as well. And then you look at the Browns, the afterthought there. Does Landry get a few more targets? Does Nick Chubb now, the unquestioned workhorse for those first 8 weeks until Kareem Hunt comes? That's humongous value for Nick Chubb there as well, being that unquestioned workhorse. You got Dontrell Hilliard. He might take some receptions, some third downs, but ultimately I think that's the Nick Chubb show. He's going to be potentially the top scoring running back in that offense, which we're going to talk about in a little bit. That explosive attack, unquestioned workhorse duties is humongous for Nick Chubb. But of course, you got to also keep in mind Kareem Hunt coming in. Big stock up for Kareem Hunt as well. Unquestioned third down role when he comes back in week 9, but that's the one wart with Nick Chubb. But he definitely moved up my big board right outside the fringe of the first round and into that tier, more so with the Mixons and the Gurleys rather than the Marlon Max and the Derrick Henrys. So big news for Browns, big news for the Texans, a lot of impact. A guy like Duke Johnson causing fantasy shockwaves last week.